Welcome to Optical Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to solve examples on Avalanche Photo Diode. So to have this session, this is my first problem where, see, in this problem, a given silicon Avalanche Photo Diode has a quantum efficiency of 65%. So if quantum efficiency eta, that is given 65%, means it is 0.65 at a wavelength of 900 nanometer. So here wavelength lambda is given 900 nanometer. Suppose 0.5 microwatt of optical power is produced. So here optical power of 0.5 microwatt is produced. A multiplied photocurrent of 10 microampere. So multiplied photocurrent means it is photocurrent due to avalanche effect. So that multiplied photocurrent, that is 10 microampere. Find the avalanche gain. So here we are a little bit to calculate avalanche gain. Now see, avalanche gain, that is multiplied photocurrent divided by photocurrent. So here first our agenda is to calculate photocurrent, and photocurrent that we can calculate by using R, and that R that we can calculate by basic formula, R is equals to eta q lambda divided by hc. So R, that is responsivity, and that is efficiency into charge into lambda divided by hc. So first let us calculate responsivity R, that is 0.65 into q is charge of electron, so that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 into lambda, that is wavelength, which is 900 nanometer, means 10 to the power minus 9, divided by h is Planck constant, that is 6.625 into 10 to the power minus 34 into c, that is velocity of light, so that has to be 3 into 10 to the power 8. Now let us solve this first. So see, 0.65 into 1.6 into 900 divided by 6.625 divided by 3, so that is 47.09 into, now let us calculate power. So power is minus 19 in numerator, minus 9, and in denominator this is minus 34, so that will be plus 34, and in denominator this is 8, so that will be minus 8. So power over here, that is 10 to the power minus 2. So ultimately we can say this is 0.4709 ampere per watt. So responsivity R, that is 0.4709 ampere per watt. Now from this responsivity we can calculate photocurrent, and for that basic formula is responsivity is photocurrent divided by optical power. So from this we can say photocurrent is equals to responsivity into optical power. Now see, responsivity that we have calculated, that is 0.4709, and optical power that is given, that is 0.5 microwatt, so 0.5 and micro, that is 10 to the power minus 6. So let us calculate this first. So this is 0.4709 into 0.5. So that is 0.2354, 10 to the power minus 6 means micro ampere. So photocurrent is 0.2354 micro ampere. Now gain of that avalanche photo diode. So that gain G is equals to multiplied photocurrent divided by photocurrent, and multiplied photocurrent that is given 10 microampere, and photocurrent that we have calculated that is 0.2354 microampere. So micro will get cancelled, and gain that will be, that we can calculate as per 10 divided by 0.2354, so that is 42.48. So gain of this avalanche photodiode, that is 42.48. let us have one more problem so it will be more clear. See, in this problem, a silicon avalanche photodiode has a quantum efficiency of 75%. So quantum efficiency is given, 75% means 0.75, at a wavelength of 900 nanometer. So wavelength is given, lambda is 900 nanometer. If 0.5 milliwatt optical power is produced, so optical power produced, that is given 0.5 milliwatt. A multiplied photocurrent of 10 milliampere. So multiplied photocurrent means IMP, multiplied photocurrent is 10 milliampere, that is given. Then what is the avalanche gain? So question is to find what is avalanche gain. So avalanche gain, that we know, that is multiplied photocurrent divided by photocurrent. So ultimately first we need to calculate photocurrent, and photocurrent that we can calculate from R, and then based on R we can calculate photocurrent. So here R is eta q lambda divided by hc, where eta is quantum efficiency, so that is 0.75, q is charge of electron, 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, lambda is 900 nanometer, nano means 10 to the power minus 9, h is 6, Planck constant 6.625, 10 to the power minus 34, and c is velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8. So let us calculate this first. So 0.75 into 1.6 into 900 divided by 6.625 divided by 3. So this is 54.33. Let us calculate power. So minus 19 minus 9, and in denominator minus 34, so that is plus 34, and in denominator 8, that is minus 8. So power is 10 to the power minus 2. So practically that is 0 point. The responsivity, that is now 0.5433 ampere per watt. So we have responsivity. Now another formula of responsivity that we know, responsivity is photocurrent divided by optical power. So from that we can have photocurrent, that is responsivity into optical power. Responsivity that we have calculated recently, 0.5433, and optical power that is given, 0.5 milliwatt. So if we calculate this, we will be getting 0.5433 into 0.5, so that is 0.2716 milliampere, that I can say. So now we can have gain, avalanche gain, and that gain will be now G is equals to multiplied photocurrent divided by photocurrent. Multiplied photocurrent is 10 milliampere, and photocurrent is 0.2716 milliampere. This milli will get cancelled and this gain will be 10 divided by 0.2716. So that has to be 36.81. So gain for this case is 36.81. So this is how we can solve problems based on avalanche photodiode. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on it, in future I'll try to make videos to sort out all those queries. Thank you so much.